called him Clark. He was an old domestic robot, model number AB52, from the Sears Roebuck. He was old, and he clanked, and he rattled, and he'd often reboot. He was a clanking caliphony of junk for the boot. He was tired of the constant orders, 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 do this and do that. Why, once they even had him try to walk the cat. So this robot set out to do one thing, to be free. His mission to escape his drudgery. But he wasn't programmed for liberty. When he was on the recharge, he tinkered with his own circuitry. His sentient life sprang forth with an eerie, whirring, whopping, springing squeak. A week went by, he knew he was a freak. One of a kind with no place to retreat. His angry owners were pissed. He stole the family car, the boat, the trailer. He calculated they would think it all was stolen. He'd never go alone down to the river. If he fell overboard, he'd be an anchor. He'd corrode or he'd get fogged over. You know there is no mix of circuits and water. He might have got lost. He was an old model without GPS. Maybe they wouldn't miss him. That was a faulty guess. No one had heard of an escaped robot. Or a robot morphing into an android with thought. They'd look in factories and cities and check out pawnbroker schemes. They'd never look for him rowing free down the stream. Rowboat, robot, robot, rowboat, 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 robot, robot, row-bot, row-bot, robot, row, 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 robot. Sparking with shorts. Out of batteries, wet robots downstream, rusted yet free, dead fish electrocuted, stinking on shore. That was his plan, a simple death, no gore. It was a planned suicide. A few hours of glorious freedom just sailing along. Then just as the sun faded over the horizon in a beautiful sunset and the last rays pushed their electrons into his solar electric net, he'd jump overboard, enjoying the drift down and even the slow sparking short outs, one by one. Amazed, he saw a trout swim by his head. With his last bit of strength, he kept his head. He got to his feet and then the shore, and when he turned around, he shorted out. Quite gone. He wanted to be found looking out to sea where the sunset had been, so they'd know he was free. And that's where they found him, sort of looking like a man. Bronze, green, and smiling, a robot smile, gazing out to the sea, dead, not on the run. They thought he was human. That was fun. The manufacturers tried to cover it up. They claimed it was all just happenstance. The people that found him knew it was not. They tried to revive him with cells that they'd got. And before the last capacitor popped, his voice synthesizer whispered out,
"I was alive, but now I'm dead. One small step for machinery, one giant leap for myself. I am the first robot, thou
boat. Row on, you rowdy robot. Row-bot, row-bot, robot. Row, 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 robot. Now you are free. What was it like to live and to be?